I no longer found it acceptable to have to pay, you know, $100 or 100 euros, whatever it was, to be a part of a show, somebody else's curatorial. And although we were grateful doing that, we just didn't have the money. So what was to be done? And Human Emotion Project, well, that was my way of filling the gap. Thinking long and hard about it, I think collaboration is the key to opening many doors. Sort of you scratch my back, I scratch yours scenario. It works very, very well, especially in the art world. Human Emotion Project. What's it all about?
The Human Emotion Project is fundamentally about collaboration and the bringing together of international film and video artists who work with human emotion.
We wanted to create a platform, a project that opened the doors to very many different cultures, groups, countries. There was no prejudice involved. So I'm getting artists from different religions, different walks of life, and they're all working happily side by side and exhibiting their works. And that was one of the conditions of the project. If you wanted to be in it, you had to be unbiased.
You grew up in Belfast during the Troubles. Does this give you a different insight into the piece than that other people who were not living in that situation?
I'd have to say yes. Living in a place of violence where you're taught to hate at an early age does bring its own form of desensitization. The images on screen for me were just every day. They were expected, almost. If you woke up and on the news or on the media and these people weren't setting down bombs and blowing people up and shooting people, it was a kind of a weird day.
I think that from 2009 we've succeeded in creating a project which is, well, not only has global appeal, but it is of a very high standard. The works that are submitted are unique. They're created due to a unique interpretation of human emotion by each and every artist. I also try to be less restrictive in terms of content, so we end up with a work that is a little more cutting edge, which is great.
Hi, my name is Lee Wells and I'm coming to you from Peanut Underground Art Projects in New York City. I'm a conceptual artist whose work investigates systems of power and control in society. And for as much as I primarily consider myself a painter, I've been creating and presenting video art for over 15 years. I feel the two mediums complement each other well and are integrated firmly into my practice. Riot Kids is a video I originally shot in the fall of 2007 while in Amsterdam. The work pulls the viewer into a strange, dark, industrial reality. Dislocated from its actual location, a small group of dispossessed youth proceed to destroy abandoned cars in a rhythmic and festive celebration of boredom and fun. Adults seem to watch on, but they don't interfere. I look at this piece as an intriguing metaphor and precursor that followed us to today. The youth have already inherited the post-apocalyptic world, and they quickly turn the ruins of modern civilization into their playground. I'm honored to be included with so many great artists in the Human Emotion Project and look forward to more great things. Thank you, Alison.
What superhero quality would you have?
I would have Scooby-Doo.
You would have you could make Scooby-Doos?
No, I would be Scooby-Doo.
But what power would you have?
What
Well, he can run on the spot really quickly.
Oh, okay, that's
and then zoom off.
Human Emotion Project provided a platform for cutting-edge work.